Carcassonne is a French fortified city in the department of Aude, in the region of Occitanie. Inhabited since the Neolithic period, Carcassonne is located in the plain of the river Aude between historic trade routes, linking the Atlantic to the Mediterranean Sea and the massive central to the Pyrenees. Its strategic importance was quickly recognized by the Romans, who occupied its hilltop until the demise of the Western Roman Empire. Being located in France, the climate is very peculiar, and we'd like to talk a bit about it in our first segment. The climate. In Carcassonne, the summers are short, warm, dry, and mostly clear, and the winters are long, very cold, and partly cloudy. Over the course of the year, the temperature typically varies from 37 degrees Fahrenheit to 83 degrees Fahrenheit, and is rarely below 28 degrees Fahrenheit or above 92 degrees Fahrenheit. The warm season lasts for 2.9 months from June 15th to September 12th, with an average daily high temperature above 76 degrees Fahrenheit. The hottest day of the year is August 4th, with an average high of 83 degrees Fahrenheit and low of 64 degrees Fahrenheit. The cool season lasts for 3.8 months from November 17th to March 9th, with an average daily high temperature below 56 degrees Fahrenheit. The coldest day of the year is January 12th, with an average low of 37 degrees Fahrenheit and high of 49 degrees Fahrenheit. In Carcassonne, the average percentage of the sky covered by clouds experiences significant seasonal variation over the course of the year. The clearest part of the year in Carcassonne begins around June 13th and lasts for 3.3 months, ending around September 24th. On July 21st, the clearest day of the year, the sky is clear, mostly clear, or partly cloudy 80% of the time, and overcast or mostly cloudy 20% of the time. The cloudier part of the year begins around September 24th and lasts for 8.7 months, ending around June 13th. On January 1st, the cloudiest day of the year, the sky is overcast, or mostly cloudy 59% of the time, and clear, mostly clear, or partly cloudy 41% of the time. To characterize how pleasant the weather is in Carcassonne throughout the year, we compute two travel scores. The tourism score favors clear, rainless days with perceived temperatures between 65 degrees Fahrenheit and 80 degrees Fahrenheit. Based on this score, the best time of year to visit Carcassonne for general outdoor tourist activities is from early June to late September, with a peak score in the second week of July. Based on the relaxing and pleasant atmosphere, you will feel the locals' happiness and gratitude. The locals are also very pleasant and hospitable, so let's talk about them in our next segment. The people. Besides some interesting regional museums, there are three museums well worth a visit. LAC, or L'Art d'Art Contemporain, Insigian, the Musée de l'Art Moderne in Serret, where Serret has been home to many painters and artists between 1910 and 1925, like Braque, Chagall, Picasso, and Soutine. And the Théâtre Musée d'Ali a Figueras, just over the Spanish border and not far from beautiful Barcelona. During the summer months, several wine estates organized art exhibitions, either presenting one artist or providing a more general exhibition like Château de Jau with its modern art. In several villages, one finds galleries with works of interesting regional artists. Toulouse, just 1 hour from Le Trabet, offers a variety of exhibitions and galleries. Antique and brocante shops are to be found all over the Aude, as well as in the Vide Grenier, organized by villages from time to time during the summer. And as with most places, things weren't always like this, and so we'll tell you a bit about this city's history in our next segment. The history. The city of Carcassonne is primarily known as a fortified medieval town, but its history is much more ancient. Oppidum transformed in the 1st century BC into a Roman city. The city became, during the 11th century, a possession of the powerful Viscount Trencavel, who was then dominating the Tower Languedoc. After the Albigensian Crusade, the city, with new fortifications, became one of the emblematic strongholds of the kingdom, on the border between France and Aragon. The construction of the outer wall and the modernization of the inner wall makes this place an unassailable fortress. With the Treaty of the Pyrenees in 1659, which connects the Roussillon to France, the city lost its strategic role, stopping its defenses works. In the 19th century, thanks to the joint action of Carcassonne and the historical monuments, its restoration is confided in Eugène Violette-le-Duc, the ancient fortress regains its past appearance. It is now listed on the UNESCO World Heritage List. It remains the most formidable series of fortifications that can still be admired in Europe. A veritable anthology of stone, throughout its 3 kilometers of ramparts, through its 52 towers, 2 gates, its barbicans, its castle and its basilica in the labyrinth of its crenellated ramparts, its stairs, its chicanes and gates, you can read the whole architecture of the Middle Ages. On the west side of the fortification rests the castle built in the 12th century by the Viscounts Trencavel. Constantly changed over the centuries, a veritable fortress within a fortress, it now houses a lapidary museum. It has a large collection of relics from the city and the region. Regional sculptures from Gallo-Roman to 17th century, stelae, sarcophagi, capitals, bowl of the Abbey of Fontfroid in the 12th century, a magnificent Calvary of Villeneuve in the 15th century, wall paintings, statues. The Basilica of Saint Nazaire is completed in the first half of the 12th century. Redesigned several times, the building blends Romanesque and Gothic styles and has the most beautiful stained glass windows in the south of France during the 13th and 15th centuries. It lost its cathedral status in 1801 in favor of the Church of Saint Michel, located in La Bastide. It received in 1898 the title of Basilica. So now that you know a bit about Carcassonne's weather, people, and history, let's discover some more fun and interesting facts and stories in our last segment, Random Things. There are around 3 million people who come to town per year. The main tourism object visited by the people in town is the fortification. When people visit Canal du Midi, they can enjoy boat cruising. The people can also enjoy the MKE Performing Arts Academy. But also from above or below on the ramparts or inside the walls, Carcassonne's double line of fortifications are a marvel. The insurmountable walls and 52 towers are deservedly the center of attention and go on for 3 kilometers around the old upper city. You can enter the Chateau Comtal for a tour, and with an audio guide, you should expect to lose 2 awe-filled and informative hours finding out about how the walls were built in the 15th century and how they were restored in the 1800s by Violette Leduc. You can do the full walk among the battlements and between the walls. There are even jousting shows for families to watch in the summer. So there you have it. If this video convinced you or you already know that you want to visit this beautiful city, we have assembled the best list of hotels you will find anywhere, and they are all priced competitively under $100, and we would greatly appreciate it if you go and check those out. Thanks to everybody who watched, and if you enjoyed the video, make sure to hit that subscribe button, and we hope to see you in our next video.